want to give you a quick update where we're at. We're unloading 9 semis. This is what it looks like when volunteers come together. Thank you to everybody who supported. Thank you to everybody who's helped.
We love seeing that. Houstan Texan defensive end J.J. Watt was hands-on in raising over $37 million for Hurricane Harvey relief. His work off the field has made him a finalist for the NFL's Walter Payton Man of the Year Award. A little sweetness award there.
J.J. Watt joins us today as a paid spokesperson for Gatorade. What's up, man?
How's it going, guys?
I can't believe you walked in here without a coat.
And I mean, I'm missing one sock.
I'm from Wisconsin, so I mean, I have to kind of hold it down for the Wisconsin folks and be tough in the wintertime. It makes you tougher.
But it's negative out here.
Yeah, I know. I think it's like, a little mentality.
It's like,
I know it was negative. I felt it. I could tell.
Okay, were you cold or are you not even cold out there?
The last little bit of the walk, I admit I was cold. But I mean, you kind of mentally prepare yourself and you get out of the car and you're like, okay, let's do this.
The best part about your last bit of the walk is they kept you outside to take the promo. So you're like, oh, we're not even going to go inside to do this.
Okay, I hadn't prepared myself for that.
Exactly.
So that I was cold.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You're here at the Super Bowl. What's going on with Gatorade?
I'm with Gatorade. We're talking about, I mean, Gatorade's been in sports for over 50 years and obviously a big part of my life. And they have this new thing. It's a whey protein bar with almond butter. And so after a workout for me, after a rehab session, it's so great to get that protein in. Has half the sugar. So Gatorade's always been good to be in.
The big game is on Sunday.
Yeah.
The commercials are a big part of that.
Of course.
I feel like you are perfect for this.
And Gatorade has the best commercials.
They do have great commercials. I wish I was playing in the game and not in the commercials. So that's the goal. But maybe one day I can have both. So that's like the next level goal.
What is it like being here as an athlete and not being in the big show? You're so competitive.
Right.
Is it a little hard?
Yeah, of course it's frustrating. I mean, everybody wants to be here as a player and not as a spokesman or something like that. But it's motivation. I mean, every single year you come and you want to get to that game. So it's just a little bit more motivation for next year.
Can we talk about motivation real quick? Because I just saw your scar, actually,
Wow.
on your knee.
Right.
How intense was the process, I mean, in getting back to even to be able to walk again?
Yeah, no, it's obviously a very intense process. I mean, breaking my leg, no fun. Don't ever want to go through it, but throughout the process and the grind to get back up to the top is you learn you learn something about yourself every day, and it's there's ebbs and flows to it, and there's ups and downs, but keeping a positive attitude and always having that mentality that every day get a little bit better, and then I'm going to be back to myself. So it's been going really well.
What did the love of your life, Meemaw, your 100-year-old great-grandmother, say about your injury? And the crowd went nuts when they were carrying you off the field.
She's the best. She's the best. So she watches the games every Sunday, so she was sad that she didn't get to watch any more Texans games. But I have two other brothers in the league, so she got to watch them.
Bunch of underachievers.
I know. So. There she is. I mean,
and does she love social media? Did I read that right? Does she like follow?
She's
you
great. My grandma and my great grandma both. They do follow along.
They're monitors.
Yeah, so
monitors.
They check along. So,
yeah, you're not gonna be out there without a chaperone. Oh my gosh, that picture is.
Yeah, so she's the best. I mean, she's incredible, and she's still a fireball. I mean, we play cards, we play rummy together, and she'll sneak a cheat here and there. So she'll call me out if I try and sneak a cheat. So she's the best. So great grandma, grandma, I love you guys, and I hope you're having a great day.
Talk to you, though, about Houston. I mean, the work that you did there was pretty incredible. You raised a ton of money in a really short period of time. Almost raising $40 million is a big deal.
Yeah.
How did you do it?
It was the generosity of a whole bunch of people. I mean, it was hundreds of thousands of people from around the country, around the world. All I did was give them a place to donate, and their humanity, their generosity did the rest, and now we're out there distributing the funds and making sure that we're putting people back in their homes, we're giving them food, medical care, helping to rebuild daycares and things like that. So the biggest thing that I learned from it all is how much good that there is in the world.
Yeah.
You know, there's so many negative headlines in today's world. The thing that I learned from all that is there is so much good out there. It just doesn't necessarily get as many headlines, and so it was nice for this to get so much recognition to really put a light on how many good people there are in the world.
Yeah.
Have you always been like that? Like growing up, like the kid in school, were you the one like doing fundraisers or helping people out? Or?
My parents instilled it in me from a young age. I mean, we grew up, we weren't rich, but we weren't poor. I was fortunate to have a pretty good life.
Growing up. You're a big boy. I can't imagine.
No.
You know, you got to eat.
Yeah, we got to eat. And so I think that's what my parents instilled in me is they always taught me to give back and that not everybody had it as fortunate as we did. So I always wanted to give back. I started my foundation when I was in college, and we tried to. Oh man, look at my mullet!
Whoa, go back to the mullet!
Wow.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll get that coming back.
Tell me the mullet comes back.
It may have to. I mean, I don't think I can get the bleach blonde back, though. I may have to go with some artificial products there. But yeah, that's a nice mullet there.
We were just talking about your girlfriend in the break. How did you two meet, actually?
She's a Tar Heel, by the way.
She is a Tar Heel. She rubs at my face all the time. Yeah. They have soccer national championships for days.
It's like, apparently. She's a good
yeah. My girl.
But no, we met, her sister is actually married to one of my teammates. And so we met quite a few years back and have had a relationship over the years and started out as great friends. And I think that's what a great relationship is built on, is just being really good friends first. And then we built into a pretty incredible relationship. So I'm very fortunate to have her.
Now you're a romantic guy. The last
thing you
posted
right?
for her birthday was the sweetest thing. Everybody was dying. What did she think when she read all that?
Oh, I mean, she said I was sweet, which it was nice to hear.
You like
get some brownie points. Yes, thank you. But I mean, it's one of those things where it wasn't even anything, you know, that crazy. I mean, just recounting some of the things we've been through in the last year. And I think if you actually sit down and think about what you go through on a day-to-day basis with your girlfriend, whoever it may be, your loved ones, there's a lot of great moments, and it's fun to look back on those with fondness and get excited about what's in the future.
Does Meemaw like her? Does the family like her?
Oh, loves her.
Okay,
my grandma,
that's big.
It is.
Great-grandma called her and sang her happy birthday on the phone, and so she loves it.
Now, how long, though, were you calling her the wrong name?
So, I mean, her name is, she has a Hawaiian name. Her name is Kealia Ohai, and it's spelled K-E-A-L-I-A, and so I called her Kealia. And I was like,
you were putting a little
she
extra
never,
on.
Yeah, I was putting a little extra on the A. So then I started calling her Kea, and she was like, you know, it's just Kealia, right? It's just K. And I was like, that would have been good to know like 6 months ago. Like, could have hit me with that one out of the gate.
Right. So.
But now I'm the only one that calls her Kea, so I kind of have my own thing, which is good, but even if it's wrong.
Does she know about your old crush on Jennifer Aniston?
She does. And, you know, it is what it is. It was grandfathered
in.
It was grandfathered in, so it's been with me for a while. So.
But was this Rachel?
I was going to say, which Jennifer Aniston are we talking here?
A lot of them. I mean, obviously it starts out with Friends and Rachel Green, and then it kind of moves on into her movies and stuff. But I mean, I think it's, I think Rachel Green is definitely
the best.
Start of it all, of course.
So no horrible bosses.
I mean, it got up. But Kay definitely takes the cake, and she's number one. So
and I bet she loves Rachel too.
Jennifer Aniston. No, of course.
Who doesn't?
How do you not love Friends?
So. Exactly.
Yeah. We're thinking about your family, two other brothers in the NFL. Right. The other big NFL family we think of is the Gronkowskis.
Of course.
Uh-huh. If we were to do the Watts against the Gronkowskis in a dance-off, who is going to win?
Well, they have more people, so I think they could do a little bit more choreography. They have a couple more brothers, and I'm sure they're a little bit wild, but I think it would be a great dance-off. I think there's no question.
What are your moves, though?
What's the go-to? Uh-oh.
I mean, there'd probably be, I mean, we're not the most charismatic
here it is.
In the world to be dancing. There'd probably be some, like, sprinkler.
I like it.
Okay.
Probably try the worm. The shopping cart, absolutely. I mean,
the shopping cart.
The Macarena.
What's the shopping
this
cart?
This guy.
The shopping cart. You push it down, you grab the stuff off the shelves.
Oh, yeah. See that? Roll some Gronk for me. He just does, like, a leg kick. Give me some Gronk dancing, because I think you got him, JJ.
What's that? Put it away?
That's like a full body seizure, right?
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't know what that is. Now he's a rocket.
It, though. I think that's the key. You just got to get it. You just got to get it.
You got to own
passion,
it.
You do it.
But now we're in Wisconsin, too, though. I mean, in Minnesota, too, though, right? Like, I feel like the beer drinking capital of the world. Who can slam more, you think?
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to give that to them. I think they got the corner on it. I enjoy a nice beer, but I think that they have a lot of practice with it.
Before we let you go, Coach Craig from Bad Moms, any more acting for you? What are we going to see?
I hope so. Yeah, I like it. I mean, I enjoy it. Obviously, with my day job, it's a little bit tough to fit in.
Oh, yeah, that old day job.
But I love it. I really enjoy it. I'm hoping to get into acting some more and do some more stuff. So the Coach Craig role is a lot of fun and doing some stuff on New Girl and stuff like that. So I think hopefully down the line there's some more stuff.
Hey, now.
Who's going to win?
I mean, it's hard to go against the Patriots. I mean, they've won. Obviously, Tom's won 5, and they've been in 8 of the last 16 or whatever it is. I have a lot of teammates on the Eagles, but, I mean, it's always tough to go against the greatest of all time.
So you're thinking Patriots.
I mean, it's hard to go against them. Yeah, I don't know how you pick against a team like that, but if anybody can do it, the Eagles have an underdog story this year, and obviously they're embracing that whole underdog status, so we'll see. But, I mean, I think the Patriots always have great odds.
Well, good luck with Man of the Year. Indeed. Our money's on you. The Thanks. Sweetness Award is coming to you, the great J.J. Watt.